Housing Development Program, your usual encyclopedia on housing matters.
Guaranteeing often a part of the enabling environment that somebody will buy what you build. Government can also play that role. And we have seen multiple roles of financiers and developers played by Federal Mortgage Bank. And the question is being asked, which one does Federal Mortgage Bank want to do? Do they want to finance or do they want to develop? And I think that they should maintain their lane before they go and get accidents. So we will go back and work with them to see how we can help them complete all those uncompleted projects, and they should stay in providing mortgage after that. We have heard also about how the much-touted pension funds should not be invested at the construction stage because it is risky there, and we don't want pensioners to lose their money, but that it can come later at the acquisition stage to fund and support mortgage, because there is now an asset against which the money charges. And so if there is default, at least the pension fund can still dispose of that asset and recover under the right of the mortgagor. And in response to the question about whether you can invest part of your equity, yes, indeed you can. The law has been amended to allow you to do so, and regulations have been made to permit you to do up to 25% of the amount in your entire savings account. So pension reforms and policies from the National Assembly as an arm of government are some of the incentives that are beginning to creep slowly but surely into the sector. We have also seen the need and the possibility for offtake of increased utilization of bonds and REITs in order to finance. We have learned about informal settlements. Hanyi Danyaro in Zaria was a typical example, and how to build around there rather than eliminating them. And we need to solve the problem of title. There's a presidential committee on land titles that has come to see me, and one of the things we are thinking about is how maybe the federal government should take over the responsibility and do a complete area survey, GIS survey of the entire country as its investment. I think that we are clearly on the right track. We have had a no-holds-barred summit where we have exchanged ideas, and I believe that this will help us to explode all the myths, to tell members of the expecting public that there is no hard and fast rule about affordable housing, but that it is not the same thing as low-cost housing, and that not everybody can own a house, but for those who cannot yet own a house, we will do our best to ensure that they have shelter that they can pay for by way of rental income as they get up. We have heard how a carpenter took 15 years to build his own house. And the story here will not just be about building houses. It will ultimately get to providing site and service schemes for those who want to build by themselves as we go on. And those schemes, of course, will also be defined by where the land is located and those who want to live there. And perhaps it will be easier to drive those kind of schemes more effectively using the cooperatives that we have talked about. Let me just go to the conclusions of our communique. And it's a rather long communique. It is the result of the hard work that all of us have done here. I would ask the Secretariat to make electronic copies available somewhat, but the recommendations identify as follows: the need to agree on acceptable definition of affordable housing by all stakeholders, appreciated the roles of the Ministries of Power, Works and Housing, the Ministry of Finance and their affiliate agencies, and that of governments at both states and federal level, as well as that of the private sector champions and developers. It recommended the development of sectoral policies on affordable housing in consonance with the provisions of the various acts and bills on land utilization for housing. It recommended also that the Land Use Act be retained, but that the state and federal government should endeavor to evolve reforms in land administration, such as titling that we have done, mapping that we have talked about, to make actual land allocation and accessibility affordable to developers and end users by simplifying the issue of title documents. On financing, we stress the need to provide local solutions to mortgage financing by considering generational mortgage financing where tenure could be extended beyond the original mortgagee for continuity. The need to maintain single-digit interest and, if necessary, subsidies for low-income earners. The need to recapitalize the Federal Mortgage Bank of Nigeria and the National Housing Fund contribution. The need to attract pension funds into financing mortgage acquisitions rather than construction development. The need to put in place appropriate construction financing, including sourcing of funds for multilateral schemes. It urged stakeholders to join the ministry in liaison with the National Assembly to fast track the amendment of laws already submitted relating to foreclosure, mortgage, and insurance, and so on. On concessions and incentives, this summit identified the need to introduce tax exemption probably to developers who build and provide infrastructure at affordable housing sites, the need for Nigerians to patronize made in Nigeria goods, especially fittings for houses, and also made in Nigeria fittings should be given incentives to make them affordable, and the need to reduce the rate of land registration, stamp duties, and I might add, the professional fees of valuers, surveyors, and lawyers, thereby reducing the cost of housing. It's a very important point that, if you permit me, I will say a word or two about. What we have found is that land is usually undervalued, its real value not willing to be identified by the holder. In the fair, those who want to charge on it raise the percentage rate in order to come to almost the same amount. If people really accept the market value of their properties, then it is easy to bring down the rate of fees. This was one of the last decisions we took in Lagos. We reduced tax, stamp duty, registration, and all of that to a gross sum of 3% from about 13%. But we applied the rate on the market value of the property. And those rates were subject to revision as the economy changed. But we need, because it is something that is a measure of the ease of doing business in the country, and we haven't ranked very well in it. Incidentally, I saw the president of the Institute of Estate Surveyors here with us yesterday. I hope he's still here or his members are here. So we would like them also to begin to put their heads around this subject, how they can reduce these fees and make as a component of the cost of housing. On the strategic focus for off-takers, there was a need, as I said, to use cooperatives to create a critical group of off-takers, to evolve implementation strategy that involves all stakeholders from builders, developers, mortgage bankers, construction financiers, and end users and government. All federal ministries, departments, and government agencies should be mobilized to participate and take full advantage of the FISH program, which is a program championed by the Office of the Head of Civil Service of the Federation to accelerate home ownership for public servants. The indices that should be used for defining affordable housing should include segregation or stratification, classes of people and their income brackets, not more than one-third net household income of the target group, not individual income alone, and their equity contribution as end users.
Are you ready, Nigeria, for the largest home expo in West Africa, the 10th Abuja Housing Show?
Coming through from the 18th to 20th July 2016.
At the International Conference Center, Abuja, Nigeria, the show will feature a stakeholders conference on financing affordable housing, presentation and exhibition of new building technology, mortgage services and other housing products. This event is powered by Fesadev Communications, owners of Housing Program on AIT, NTA and Housing Time on Raypower. For bookings, inquiries and advert placement, call 0816-657-0090 or 0806-458-9303.
Abuja Housing Show, the largest home construction industry exhibition in West Africa.